Bible analyst and authority on the divine is fabulous. The next speaking.
As the pilgrim, 2 hours, 24 minutes, coordinated universal time.
And following several expert consultations, I have decided to raise the current level of influenza pandemic alert.
I've done many videos about radio, but one band I've never really covered in any great depth is shortwave. There's actually several radio bands of various frequencies that have been in use for almost 100 years now. And people were already declaring shortwave radio to be dead 20 years ago, because the main point of listening to shortwave radio is that you can hear radio stations from all around the world. Well, now you can do the same thing on your computer. Just go to any website, listen to any online radio stream, or watch any video stream. Anywhere in the world, you can access in perfect quality. So why listen to very poor quality, usually, radio on a shortwave radio? And it is true that many of the big shortwave radio stations that used to broadcast no longer are doing so, at least to nearly the same extent they used to. For example, BBC discontinued the world service on shortwave, I believe, over a decade ago. And same thing for Radio Moscow. And the US may still do some broadcasts on shortwave with Voice of America, but they mostly aim it towards third world countries and other parts of the world, not really towards North America or Europe. So most of what you find on shortwave these days are religious broadcasts and radio broadcasts from Cuba and China. I know China is actually leasing the transmitters that Radio Canada used to use. When they shut down about a decade ago, they leased their transmitters to Radio China, sometimes in English. The same thing with Cuba. They often broadcast in English. And you can also hear time signal stations such as WWV and CHU, and there's one in Japan, JJY, and I think there's also one in Russia and one in China. Those are the major time signal stations that you can pick up. And radio amateurs or ham radio operators use many of the shortwave bands, although most of them transmit in single sideband, which only this receiver can pick up. All the other ones cannot, including this new one I just got, this Kaito Voyager. You can get this for about $50 on Amazon. I got this for $10 at a thrift store. Works perfectly. And these are by far not the best shortwave radios you can get. Even this one, or this one. There's many more advanced ones and antennas you can use. These are just very basic ones. These are like the Crosley Cruiser of shortwave radios. So a quick look at the receivers I have. I just showed you the new Kaito Voyager. They have several models of these. All of them, I believe, include shortwave. This one is from 3.2 to 8 and 9 to 22 megahertz, which is a rather broad range for one band. So when you're tuning in a station, it doesn't have fine tuning, so it can be rather difficult to get a station tuned in. This is a Grundig shortwave radio from the 90s. Not sure the exact model. I don't think it says on it anywhere. But they had many of these little shortwave radios back then. And you can see this one includes many more shortwave bands split up into narrower frequency ranges for easier tuning. Also includes long wave, which is not used for broadcasting in North America, although we do have airport beacons on the long wave band. There it is, picking up a long wave beacon from an airport that's about 20 miles away. This one is my personal favorite, this little Radio Shack DX397, also probably from the late 90s or early 2000s. This was made by Sanjian, who made almost all of Radio Shack's shortwave radios, at least the ones from the 90s and newer. Also includes various shortwave bands, does not include long wave, but it does include, of course, AM and FM. AM is referred to as medium wave. That's based on the frequency ranges that these various bands use. Long wave on this radio is from 145 to 285 kilohertz. Medium wave, or what we know as AM in North America, is 530 to 1600, although since this was made, it was extended up to 1710 kilohertz. And shortwave, there's various bands. I think this one has the widest range of them, from 4.5 all the way up to 22.1 megahertz. And this is the most sophisticated radio of the bunch here, the Sony ICF-7600D from the 1980s, as you can tell by the styling. Although I believe they made these through the 90s as well, because they were very popular. And it shows you a map of the world on the back with the time zones. Shows you all the frequency ranges of the various shortwave bands. This one has an even wider range of frequencies it can tune in, and also covers long wave. So long wave, medium, shortwave, 153 to 29995 kilohertz, or just under 30 megahertz, and also FM 76 to 108. And of the group, this is the only one with single sideband for receiving amateur radio transmissions on shortwave. So I'm going to start with my little favorite here, the Radio Shack DX397. I turn off my fluorescent light just in case it might cause any radio interference, although it usually doesn't because it uses a magnetic ballast instead of an electronic ballast. So I'm going to start out at the lowest shortwave band, shortwave 1, which is 4.5 to 5.05, although that's just what's indicated on the dial. You can see you can go quite a bit below and above the indicated numbers. Hear that repetitive noise? I think that's, I forgot the exact name for it, but it's the government testing the ionosphere to sweep across various frequencies on a shortwave band. Okay, I'm just gonna cut into my own video here, because what I thought I was receiving was HAARP, High Frequency Active Auroral Research Program. But what I was actually receiving is CODAR, Coastal Ocean Dynamics Applications Radar. I was able to identify this through a webpage called Signal Identification on hfunderground.com, which is a very useful resource if you hear some strange noises on shortwave and you want to try to identify where they're coming from. This will likely help you do that. So this is a radio transmission relating to coastal ocean radar, and I am in a coastal area, more or less, so that makes sense. And they even have a recording of what it sounds like, and it pretty well matches what I heard. So now back to the band scan. That's WEWN, a religious broadcaster from Alabama. And maybe you can hear that interference from that testing I was referring to. One thing you can always find on shortwave is religious music, just various people singing in church, and not very good singers, but they certainly give it their best try, and it's something funny to listen to sometimes. I think the organist is doing his best job to drown out the singers. Not much on this band. There's WWV, the time signal. Unfortunately, there's some interference. Some very dissonant sounding music there. I don't know if it's just the propagation of the signal that's screwing it up, or bad recording, or what.
Volunteered to go into the countryside and the mountainous areas of Cuba to teach people how to read and write. The literacy campaign began.
I believe that's the Cuban station broadcasting in English. Alright, that's not a very good band. Let me try the next one. There we go.
De seu amigo Chico Anísio, tanto que em 1959 a cantora lançou Este Norte é a Minha Sorte, álbum que juntava várias faixas de autoria do humorista que já haviam sido gravadas e lançadas em discos de 78 rotações pela própria Dolores.
I would try to guess that language, but I know I'll probably get it wrong.
O mais importante por ter sido feita em parceria com sua mãe.
Sebastião, meu bem, anda logo bem. Vem pra mais perto de mim, cidade assim.
The propagation effects of shortwave certainly give an interesting sound effect to the music.
Larga de manhã.
The better receivers with, I forgot what they call it, selective receiver or synchronous detector, that's what it's called. It can help reduce that phasing and fading effect.
El primer clásico se canta en la casa de un buen vecino. Hay mucho ajetreo en las calles de la aldea. Más tarde, al llegar,
definitely sounds like Spanish.
A cada paso, los villancicos resuenan por doquier.
Not sure if that's also coming from Cuba.
Los cantan, los anfitriones preparan sus tradicionales regalos, rosquillos, roscos, nueces, avellanas, manzanas.
Basada en la ley, viene el enfoque internacional, respetar las reglas del mercado y garantizar la aplicación sólida de todas las medidas de reforma. De acuerdo con Kim, el sistema de OPI basado en el registro a la equidad su relación con la calidad de las empresas cotizadas conducirá sin duda a una eliminación más regular de las empresas de los mercados de obstáculos, mientras que es bastante
I'm not sure if that's also Spanish or maybe, I don't know, Italian, Portuguese.
En el mercado podría resultar más OPI con valoraciones más altas.
These Old Testament scriptures was able to make you wise unto salvation.
That's probably that station from Alabama we were listening to earlier. As you can tell by the southern accent. A lot of foreign language on that band. Some big strong signal there. Not sure what language that is, but whatever it is, it's a very strong signal. Sounds like the same song we were listening to earlier. Because many of these stations that are still on shortwave broadcast on various frequencies at the same time. Because not everyone is going to get the best results on the same frequency. And they're also often aimed in different directions. You can look up pictures online of the antennas these shortwave stations use, and they're very elaborate arrays of wires and poles and beams, and they can be rotated in different directions. Very sophisticated antennas. I think these are those bad singers in church that we were listening to earlier. We're definitely feeling the spirit tonight. This is the best part of the video here. This is what makes it worth having a shortwave radio. Who wouldn't want to listen to this? I just heard WBCQ. That's another big religious shortwave broadcaster in the U.S. So that's what we're listening to. I don't think WBCQ is necessarily a religious station. They just sell their airtime to anybody who will pay for it, and it just so happens that most of the people who pay to broadcast on their signal happen to be religious broadcasters. But anybody could buy a radio show on this station and get it on shortwave. And that's what we're hearing now, people paying to put this on shortwave radio. Oh, now they're talking in different languages, too. Let me say, if they broadcast this every night, I definitely would recommend getting a shortwave radio just to listen to this. If you wanted to know the exact frequency of this crazy religious music broadcast. It's 9455 kilohertz or 9.455. I like how the piano player is just calmly playing along steadily, nice and softly, as they continue to wail and scream and whatever.
And following several expert consultations, I have decided to raise the current level of influenza pandemic alert from phase 4 to phase
3. So much going on today.
So I guess that's it for that crazy religious music broadcast. Now we're on to another crazy religious broadcast.
And today, right now, just a few moments ago, the news people in Washington at the White House, you know, there's hundreds of them there, a mouse fell out of the ceiling.
That guy is known as Brother Stare. He has a long history. And I won't get into it here, but he's very, very popular on shortwave. And also earlier I heard Alex Jones on shortwave, because that's sort of the last refuge for these people to get their message out. So what I recommend getting a shortwave radio in 2020, when this band was declared to be obsolete over 20 years ago. Probably not, but you may pick up something interesting or unintentionally amusing, like we just did there. And if you happen to have a radio to have shortwave bands on it, give them a try, see what you can pick up. Or if you happen to find something like this at a thrift store for a couple bucks that has shortwave bands on it, maybe a fun thing to try. I tend to prefer these manually tuned ones, just because you get more direct experience and it's easier to tune across the dial and hear what you can pick up, instead of having to go step by step by step through the frequencies of a digital tuner, even though those usually have better reception. So I tend to prefer these small manually tuned shortwave radios. I just think they're more fun to use.